y en tus ojos con solo mirar que estás cansado de andar y de andar y caminar.
Is there a way to decrease malnutrition in children less than 5 years old, less than 2 years old, to prevent the 6-month-old infants from falling off the growth curve after breast milk is no longer sufficient? Miguel may not have the answers, but he is part of the solution. He's a full-time health promoter working for the San Benito Health Team. The health team has 4 full-time providers, a health educator, and an accountant. They have been working in a rural area of Guatemala called the Petén for 13 years. Miguel visits the communities every 1 to 2 months. Dutifully, he puts out the scale, gets his notebook, and begins to weigh the kids. As much as he understands that it would be useful to get the children's height as well, the overwhelming atmosphere of a small room full of children, moms, and booyah, the local word for noise, he goes with weight for age. When a child is identified below the growth curve or not having gained for 3 months, Miguel gives the mom supplemental food for the child. Currently, the team has a budget for food supplements. They are concentrating on increasing protein content and making food more tasty with oil and sugar. But does the mother use it? And if she does, how does the mother use it? To monitor the mother and child in the village, we need someone from the village to help the mother, visit her home, check in on her between Miguel's visits. Meet Elsa. She is one of the 3 village health workers in Paso Caballos. Seeing Elsa make the connection with the mother of a tiny malnourished girl was a promise of successful intervention. Elsa's presence added the cultural aspect and continuity needed to make a difference. Baby D was 13 months old. Her mother was 16 years old, married at 13, and living with her husband, who worked outside of the community. Baby D fell off the growth curve 1 month prior to our visit. She ate about 2 times per day, typically breast milk and soup. She did not speak, but could crawl, although she could not walk. Baby D's family did not have any animals, but had a traditional Mayan garden which consisted of corn, beans, and squash. There was no food visible in the kitchen. Much of the produce from the garden was sold as an additional source of income. A large portion of the family's food was purchased from the village store, which was much more expensive than if bought in town. This practice was common among the villagers. In June of this year, the 3 village health workers of Paso Caballos, along with 35 others from the surrounding area, came into San Benito for a training on malnutrition, specifically how to add protein to the diets of infants and children. One of the objectives for the course was to keep the promoters engaged, moving, not sitting. It was 95 degrees with near 100% humidity in San Benito. The trainers needed to move as well. The first activity was to divide up different food items into the Guatemalan model of the 3 trees of food, or the 3 food groups: energy, protection, and construction. There were 4 small groups, so everyone was on their feet discussing and dividing the foods. They presented their results to the larger group. The day narrowed in on construction, the protein food group. The men went to the market to see who could come back with the most grams of protein for 10 quetzales, or a little more than a dollar. The women made tortillas, adding sesame seeds to increase the protein content. They also made porridge from incaparina. Incaparina is a soy-based powder high in protein. People say it does not taste good. When they cooked the incaparina porridge, they added cinnamon, sugar, and oatmeal, and were impressed by how tasty it was. A few women also made a homemade porridge out of a combination of toasted beans, sesame seeds, and soy seeds all ground up together. The moment of the course when the village health workers really listened, no fiddling on their phones, no side conversations, was when they watched and heard the photo voice, the story of Elsa making the home visit. Now they could see what their role in the community could be. The cool thing about keeping the course simple was that the message is easy to replicate. The health workers could turn around and be the teachers. During the last session of the day, they had to plan when they were going to teach this to the mothers in their own communities. We loaded up in the truck, bounced out to a faraway village to watch what the village health workers had planned. Education. Watching the message spread. Seeing the mothers actively engaged. Realizing their children do like the Incaparina porridge. Seeing that it is easy and cheap to add sesame seeds to tortillas. We saw it all in action, and it felt successful. What makes it work? The village health worker is a respected person in the community. They have the support of a central health team. They get paid for the work they do. Will this all help malnourished children gain weight? Miguel will find out.
Que las ventanas se pueden abrir, cambiar el aire depende de ti, te ayudará.